Hi, you're watching DJ TV. Next up, we have a review of the Pioneer CDJ400. It's a multi-format deck aimed at the bedroom market, but top DJs like Sarah Main have been using it to hone their skills before going out on the road. We managed to catch up with her in the studio to find out some tips and tricks and see what her favourite features were.
CDJ400s from the guys at Pioneer. Tell me about a new product they were bringing out with some cool new features and effects on it. And they asked me to get involved with it, and I was really excited. I have two at home. I've got three CDJ1000s now and two CDJ400s, and they're just great for parties because they're compact. I can take them to my friends' villas, or I can stay at my villa when we have our massive big villa parties.
The new Pioneer deck plays MP3s, but it's a CD player at heart. Simply glide a disc into the slot loading drive and it's ready to play in under 6 seconds. It supports every type of CD too, but unfortunately not DVDs or any compressed file format other than MP3. It does support CD text and ID3 tag info very well.
Yeah, and the more information and we can put with a track, the better, I think.
Find tracks on storage discs and iPods by turning and pushing the select dial. Browse folders, genres, artists, albums, playlists, and more. Push to go deeper or hit back to come out again. When you find the track you want, just push the select dial to play.
My name's Beardy Man, and I'm going to show you how to beatbox. It goes a little something like this.
This is Pioneer's first attempt at a hard disk deck, and it's actually what makes it stand out. With this USB port, you have the option to connect and play digital files from any Windows drive or MP3 player. Connect your iPod, a laptop or portable hard disk, USB sticks, and even mobile phones.
At the moment, I'm still using CDs, but I think it's some sort of logical step forward to go to hard drive technology, just for the organisational aspect of it. Right now, I've got all my music organised on my hard drive, but then I'm burning it to CD. And that's very time consuming, and if I could cut out that process, I mean, it would be sort of logical.
Around the back there are the usual digital and analogue outputs. There's also a special mini jack that connects to your mix's fader start control, or to another CDJ for relay play. You'll find another USB port on the rear, this time for connecting the CDJ with software in your PC. As boring as it sounds, the result is actually quite the opposite. It may have taken Pioneer quite a while to make this multi-format deck, but at least they're bringing something new to the table.
I've just got my hands on Serato, and I want to check that out to maybe use in my live sets. Obviously, I've seen people use this Serato with the CDJ1000s, and actually the CDJ400s will be compatible with Serato, Traktor, even the Pioneer DJS software very soon with the new software updates. It allow me to use the hard drive technology that with the equipment that I'm used to, and which I think is necessary when you're a DJ, and the performance aspect is something you have to retain.
This USB port connects the CDJ to your PC, but we didn't expect to find a built-in sound card too. The CDJ can send audio to and from your PC, with standard Windows drivers giving around 10 milliseconds latency. This eliminates the need for sound cards and spaghetti junction behind your mixer. DVS users can lose their time-coded CDs because the CDJ's USB port supports MIDI and HID, which controls the scratch in your computer. Forthcoming ASIO drivers will bring latency down to around 1 millisecond, and the likes of Serato and Traktor are tipped to provide top performance. All the Pioneer's controls also send good old MIDI, although it's a tad limited and you'll be missing out on display readouts. The jog wheel is touch sensitive, so you can scratch and mix from CDs, hard drives, computer software and more, just as you would with vinyl. But to be frank, we didn't really expect much. The 12cm platter is 30% smaller than the industry standard CDJ-1000, and it's drastically smaller than a piece of vinyl. Even still, it's just big enough to offer great response and realistic sound quality. Scratching is easy on the wrist, as the platter is lighter than the CDJ-800 and 1000, but it does sound a little clunky in operation. While they're fun, the effects remind us that the CDJ is aimed at the bedroom market. There are 6 effects to play with, which are controlled by the jog wheel, 3 for vinyl and 3 for jog mode. In vinyl mode, the effects work when you scratch, and in jog mode, the scratch wheel adjusts settings manually. The bubble is quite a mad effect that stands out when scratching short vocal samples or any high frequency sounds. Hit the back button at any time to keep the effect going. The trans effect chops the sound in and out according to the BPM, and makes it sound like a sewing machine has been fixed to the crossfader. The wah is basically a filter, which is quite dull around the edges to be fair, but gets the job done. In vinyl mode, the filter oscillates in time with the beat. Switch off vinyl mode to access the 3 jog effects. Now you can manually control the same filter. There's a low pass around to the left, and a high pass around to the right. This is a really useful mixing tool. The hold button comes in handy, preventing the effects from reverting back to off. The jet effect is a phaser, which tries to sound like you're layering 2 tracks over each other in sync. Now the roll is the freshest sounding effect of them all, and it's the most fun as well. Grab any beat or sound by touching the platter at the right time. According to the BPM, it then repeats that grab sample 4 times every beat. Move the platter around and it pitches it up or down. Meanwhile, the track plays silently internally until you let go. So even while you are practicing to get the timing right, the beat will always come back in the right place. The final belter is the new rhythmic looping feature. As well as the usual in and out points, you can exit or re-loop instantly, and loops can be started as quickly as you can hammer the loop in button. Use the jog wheel to fix dodgy loop endings with the out trim, or the search buttons for finer frame by frame edits and builds. Now the fun starts with the rhythmic looping. Plus minus buttons automatically grab 4 beat loops. It chops them up into 4 chunks and starts the beginning of each slice. You can set the number of repeats using the plus or minus buttons, or hold them down for an instant fill, with quirky triplets too. It sounds great, and it's another signature effect from Pioneer.
The only feature I might like to take across from the CDJ-400 to the 1000 would be the rhythmic looping feature. Just because I know I could do a lot of amazing tricks with that in my sets, and I think it would be a nice feature to have always with me when I'm playing around the world. One cool thing about the CDJ-400 that might go unnoticed is the fact that you can use 2 things at once. So if you're using the loop divide, and that can be quite dramatic if you use the wah filter at the same time and bring it down, it can give more of a subtle effect.
The whole process relies on the BPM being read correctly, but it's not as solid as we'd like, and there's no tap tempo control. Most importantly, mixing with the CDJ is a real pleasure. The 100mm pitch fader is a bit cheaper than its bigger brothers, but still smooth and reliable.
The pitch control for me is smooth and fluid, and controlled enough.
Pioneer saved a few bucks by stripping most of the lights from the unit, so you need to keep an eye on the screen for feedback. Here you'll see the pitch settings. You can set the range right up to 100%, which Pioneer calls wide. Incidentally, wide control only works with CD audio, not MP3s. This button locks the pitch of the music regardless of the speed, and the quality is on par with the CDJ-1000, so top marks here. You'll also find a progress bar instead of a waveform view, and it flashes near the end of the track. Pioneer certainly didn't cut back on the cost when it came to the jog wheel, because it lights up like a Christmas tree. It follows you scratching and shows the loops in action and the playback direction. The pattern can also be changed by going into the menu, and it looks best with the lights down low. That pretty much covers it for all the advanced features, but let's take a look at the basics. You can switch off vinyl mode and use the platter to change the pitch, and flip the reverse button to change the playback direction instantly. You can quick scan through tracks and folders using the search buttons and jog wheel together. Queuing in jog mode is standard issue. You get the usual stutter noise to find the downbeat with the jog wheel. Or refine it even more using the search buttons to move frame by frame. Finally, hit cue to set the point. You can now stutter this cue point like a sampler and play this into your mix. You can follow a performance by hitting the play button to launch into the track with flair. Or you can use vinyl mode to manually drop the track into the mix, just like you would with a record.
When I'm mixing, I'm mainly, well, I'm always using the vinyl mode. I always use it, you know, I guess that's from, you know, that's from me coming from the vinyl days, you know, I like starting my music like that, so.
We could easily overlook Pioneer's cue feature, but it can actually do quite a lot. It can auto cue the beginning of a track, which saves time in the mix. You can also set a cue point instantly with the loop in button. One cue or loop can be stored per track, permanently to memory. Simply hit memory once and the memory light goes on. And if you eject the disc and change your mind, it plays from that point when popped back in.
I use them for acapellas, and so I can use, you know, one word stabs and stuff like that.
You can easily back up all this data onto a memory stick and take it around with you. You can even mask two CDJs with the same info. Another great feature is you can take that disc around a mate's house and play on their decks as if they were your own. For 449, what you get is pretty unrivaled. It offers a leading scratch performance, extensive software integration, and another funky first from the rhythmic looping. The BPM is a bit limited with no tap though, and no Mac or HFS support is a downside, and the lack of support for anything other than MPC is just shoddy. We also found that our iPod would occasionally hang, so it's not recommended for professional clubs. As a CD deck, the CDJ400 is faultless. No matter what you mix with, the 400 can accommodate too, as long as you have the right formatted data. It has great effects to play with and will work as an integral part of almost any given bedroom setup. So if you want a player that will cover all bases for bedroom use, house parties and even small clubs, the CDJ400 is really worth a look.
So with all the new technology, I find DJing quite exciting at the moment because there's so many possibilities.